Today, I'm gonna show you how to use the new hue adjustment tools in Lightroom. Hey there and welcome to Phlearn. My name is Aaron Nace. You can find me on phlearn.com where we make learning fun. And I'm so excited about this video because we got a huge update to Lightroom. Basically, Lightroom has never been that good when it comes to changing a color. Like if you were wearing a blue shirt and you want it to be a green shirt, most of the time for me, I would just say go into Photoshop for doing that. But now Lightroom actually has the tools necessary to get the job done. So we're gonna show you how to do it. You can actually use the radial adjustment, the graduated filter, and the adjustment brush. All three of those tools will work. And because of a feature called range masking, you can choose specifically just the colors you wanna change and leave all the colors around it intact. So here we are in the Lightroom. I've got two different photos for you. The first one we're gonna work on is our little lollipop here. How fun. You can actually download these images on phlearn.com. Just follow the link in the description right down below. So we're gonna go to our develop module here, and the tools we wanna focus here are on the top right. So we have a graduated filter, our radial filter, and the adjustment brush. So being that this is a round lollipop, I'm gonna choose my radial filter. So let's go ahead and click on our radial filter, and this is our new hue adjustment, and isn't it pretty? Let's go ahead and just click right here and drag out to select an area. Now, by default, you have a couple options down here on the bottom. One is where it says show edit pins. I like to just put this on auto. That way, if I hover away from my image, it just goes away so I can just see what my image is. Also, it says show selected mask overlay. We're gonna go ahead and check that. That'll just turn wherever is affected. It'll just make it red. I know the image is already pretty red, but you do see the effect. Now, in this case, it's actually doing the opposite of what we want. So in that case, just go right down over here and click invert. Okay, and now you can see it's just affecting inside of this area. And then if you want to just change the softness of the edge, just work with feathering here. So more or less feathering. If you wanted to like make an area of your photo brighter, usually I would turn the feathering all the way up. But in this case, if I wanted to just like only select a certain area, we would want to bring our feathering down. You can always hover back over it and change where this actually is. Now, don't forget, this is not the only tool. So if you don't have a perfect circle, like I don't have a perfect circle in this case, you could always adjust it with the brush afterwards if you need to. But we're gonna do a whole other image and I'll show you guys how to do that. So now that I have it basically highlighted in the area I want to be affected, let's go ahead and unclick show selected mask overlay so I can actually see what I'm doing here. By default, it's just gonna push the exposure up one stop. So let's just bring that back down to zero. And now we have our hue slider. So the hue slider, pretty straightforward. Basically just click and drag this to the left or the right, and it's going to allow you to adjust the hue in the area that you selected with either your graduated, radial, or adjustment brush. And it works really, really well. It works just like expected. It's pretty coarse adjustments, so they have this use fine adjustments here, which will allow you to just make a lot more subtle adjustments, which is super helpful. Now, let's go ahead and uncheck that. I wanna just crank this over to the right. Ooh, that looks beautiful. I do wanna show you how to add to this selection. So let's go ahead and just zoom in here. Okay, I'm gonna hold down a space bar and just click to zoom in. And then I can always click right up here on the brush. There we go. And then I'm gonna get a little plus icon. I can use my open and close brackets here. And this is literally just gonna allow me to add to my radial filter, okay? So you're not stuck with just a radial or just a graduated filter. You can always use your adjustment brush to come in here and kind of paint and make it, you know, make it actually work for you. And there's full tablet support here too. So if you want to use a pressure sensitive tablet, you can do that as well. All right, you can hold Alt or Option if you want to. Let's just make this brush a little bit smaller. There we go. You can hold Alt or Option and paint out, and it'll minus that area away. So if you wanted to do, you know, if you wanted to do just the top of an object or something like that, that's how you would do it. Okay, and then you can see, in this case, just the top of my little lollipops being selected, being shifted in terms of hue. So that's pretty cool. Now, one thing that immediately came to mind is like, okay, well, that's nice if you just want to change all of the colors in your image. And you can see here it changed, you know, we've got like purple and green, where it used to be kind of like red and turquoise. It's adjusting all of the hue. But what if you want to just target a specific hue and adjust that? Because it's a lot more common, and obviously we need to be able to do that. So let's go ahead and take a look at this image here of our flower. And I just want to change the color of the flower. I don't want to change the green, you know, that for obvious reasons, it should be green. So let's go to our develop module. And this time around, we're going to use our adjustment brush. Now you couldn't use your graduated filter too. I don't, you know, I'm choosing the brush just so I can paint in the exact area that I want. But you can, again, use any of these filters. You'll have the same options with all of them. So let's go ahead and choose show mask overlay here. I'm going to go ahead and turn my flow up. There we go. And we'll bring our feathering down. And this is just going to allow me to paint over the area I want to affect. So again, it's just I'm painting right over top of the flower here. But you're going to see I'm purposely not doing a great job. That sounded like I would do a great job if I really wanted to. Purposely. Anyway, let's go ahead and zoom in here, and you can see I painted over the flower and I painted a little bit over this green area too. So the nice thing about this tool is you don't have to be like the perfect painter to get a good selection out of it because of range masking, which is a feature that was introduced about a year ago. So let's go ahead and start it off here. I'm just gonna, by default, it wants to bring my exposure up one. So let's go ahead and pop that back down to zero. Let's just turn this show selected mask overlay back off, and we're gonna start adjusting our hue. So let's say, I've never seen a blue flower. Let's make it blue. Okay, and that looks great. Only problem is if I zoom in, you can see, yeah, we have a blue flower, but it's colored this area as well. Now, of course, you could go in here with your brush tool, okay? And you can hold Alt or Option, which brings up your little minus. Okay, we're just gonna bring our size down and our feathering down a little bit there. So you can just minus out and then paint away where you don't want it to be visible. But what I think is actually a lot more efficient is to use range masking. So range masking basically allows you to just affect an area based on light values. So if an area is light or dark, I use it a lot for like masking in skies and things like that. You can also do it based on specific color values, which is where this comes in really handy. So let's go ahead and click right here where it says range mask. We're gonna click there and go down to color. Okay, so now you have a little eyedropper and you're gonna choose the colors that you actually want to affect. So let's go ahead and click on the flower here and you can see it doesn't affect green anymore because I didn't click on green. Now you can hold shift down and click and add a couple colors if you want to. So if you're like, I wanna affect all these colors over here, boom, 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 then perfect. I'm basically just affecting those colors. So what I'm telling the tool to do is first I started off with my adjustment brush and I painted in the general area. I wanted it to be visible. And then with range masking, I'm basically telling it, hey, really just affect these reds. So now I'm able to adjust the hue here in Lightroom of just the reds. And you can see I didn't go back in and make my selection better. I didn't unpaint over the green, but the range masking kind of takes care of that for me, which is honestly fantastic. Basically, up until this update, this is not something that I would personally suggest doing in Lightroom. Now it's actually a viable option, which is really cool. So if you're a Lightroom user and you don't wanna, you know, have to go into Photoshop just to change a hue, you've got the option for the first time ever. So for me, it's really exciting. Lightroom is actually getting super powerful and I'm spending more and more time editing in Lightroom. It's a raw editor, which means you get all of the power of your original raw images. So I think this is a great addition to Lightroom and I would love to learn your thoughts. So if you have any cool ideas of things that can be done with this hue adjustment tool, leave them in a comment right down below and I can make tutorials for you. Thank you so much for watching. If you want to get a free tutorial every single week delivered right to your YouTube inbox, just click on that subscribe button. And if you want to become a Photoshop and Lightroom professional, check out Phlearn Pro. We've got hundreds and hundreds of tutorials teaching everything from retouching to compositing to high-end luminosity masking and everything in between. Thank you so much for watching. I'll Phlearn you later. Bye, everyone.